Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen the classification of the binary codes and we have briefly talked about the sum of the binary codes. So in this video, we will learn about the BCD codes. So this BCD stands for binary coded decimal. So in this BCD code, each decimal digit is encoded by the group of 4 binary digits. Now there are various types of BCD codes, but the most widely used BCD code is the 8421 code. So here, this 8421 represents the weight of each position in this 4-bit binary code. That means starting from the MSB, the weight of each bit is 8, 4, 2 and the 1 respectively. And the summation of all these weights represents the equivalent decimal digit. For example, if you take this BCD code 0011, then there is a 1 in the position of 2 and 1. That means here, these two 1s will get multiplied by their corresponding weight. And the summation of all these weights represents the equivalent decimal number. Similarly, if you see this code 1001, then there is a 1 in the position of 8 and 1. So if you do the summation of all these weights, then it is equal to 9. That means this is the decimal equivalent number which is being represented by this particular code. And this is how this decimal digit 0 to 9 are represented in this 8421 code. So now, since this 8421 BCD code is a most popular one, so from now onwards in the video, I would simply refer it as a BCD code. And whenever I am referring to any other BCD code, then I will mention it explicitly. Alright, so now let's see how to convert any decimal number into the equivalent BCD code. And let's say we want to convert this decimal number 23 into the equivalent BCD code. So for the decimal to BCD conversion, we will represent each decimal digit with the corresponding BCD code. So here, the BCD code of the decimal number 2 is equal to 0010. Similarly, the BCD code of the decimal digit 3 is equal to 0011. That means if we see the overall BCD code, then this is the overall BCD code of the number 23. So for the fractional number also, the rules remains the same. So let's say, we want to convert this decimal number 56.79 into the equivalent BCD number. So once again, let us replace each decimal digit with the corresponding BCD code. So here, these 5 can be replaced as 0101, while the 6 can be replaced with 0110. Similarly, after this decimal point, the 7 can be replaced as 0111, while the 9 can be replaced with 1001. So this is the BCD equivalent of the given decimal number. So that is how we can convert any decimal number into the equivalent BCD code. Now in general, if you want to find the BCD equivalent code of any number which is being given in the base B number system, then first of all, we can find the equivalent decimal number and then we can do the decimal to BCD conversion. So that is how we can convert any number into the equivalent BCD code. So let's say, we want to find the BCD equivalent code of this hexadecimal number 5C. So first of all, let us do the hexadecimal to decimal conversion. So in the earlier videos, we have already seen that how to convert any hex number into the decimal equivalent number. And for that, let us multiply each hex digit with their corresponding weight. So here in the decimal, this C corresponds to 12. And the weight of this C is equal to 16 to the power 0. That means it is equal to 1. Similarly, the weight of this digit 5 is equal to 16. So if you do the summation of all these weights, then it is equal to 92. That means the decimal equivalent of this hex number 5C is equal to 92. So now, let us perform the decimal to BCD conversion. And for that, let us replace each decimal digit with the corresponding BCD code. So here, this 9 can be replaced with 1001. While the 2 can be replaced with 0010. So this is the BCD equivalent code of the hex number 5C. So in this way, we can perform the hexadecimal to BCD conversion. So similarly, now let us see the octal to BCD conversion. And for this octal to BCD conversion also, the procedure will remain the same. That means first of all, we will find the decimal equivalent of the given octal number, and then we will perform the decimal to BCD conversion. So let's say we want to find the BCD equivalent code of this octal number 621. And for that, let us find the decimal equivalent of this octal number. So for this octal to decimal conversion, let us multiply each octal digit with their corresponding weight. And if we do the summation of all the weights, then we will find the equivalent decimal number. So here, the weight of this digit 1 is equal to 8 to the power 0, or we can say that it is equal to 1, while the weight of this digit 2 is equal to 8. And likewise, the weight of this digit 6 is equal to 64. So if we do the summation of all these weights, then the equivalent decimal number is equal to 401. So now, let us do the decimal to BCD conversion. And for that, let us replace each decimal digit with their corresponding BCD code. So here, these are the equivalent BCD codes of the given decimal digits. And if we combine all these groups, then this is the BCD equivalent code of the octal number 621. So similarly, let us take one more example on binary to BCD conversion. So for a binary to BCD conversion also, the procedure will remain the same. That means first of all, we will do the binary to decimal conversion, and then we will perform the decimal to BCD conversion. So let's say we want to find the BCD equivalent code for the given binary number. And for that, first of all, let us do the binary to decimal conversion. So for this binary to decimal conversion, let's multiply each binary digit with their corresponding weights. And if we add all these weights, then we will get the equivalent decimal number. So here, as you can see, there are only 4 ones in this given number. And here are their corresponding weights. So if we add all these weights, then their summation is equal to 202. So that is the decimal equivalent of the given binary number. Now for the decimal to BCD conversion, let us replace each digit with their corresponding BCD code. So these are the BCD codes for the digit 0 and the 2. And if we combine all these groups, then this is the BCD equivalent number of the given binary number. So that is how we can find the BCD code for the any given number. Alright, so now so far in our discussion, we have only seen the most popular 8421 BCD code, right? But as I mentioned earlier, there are also other types of BCD codes, like a 2421, 5421, and the 84-2-1. So in this 2421 code, starting from the MSB, the weight of each digit is 2, 4, 2 and the 1 respectively. Similarly, if we talk about this 5421 code, then starting from the MSB, the weight of each digit is 5, 4, 2 and the 1 respectively. And the same is applicable for this other code. So this is how the decimal digit 0 to 9 are represented in these different BCD codes. And if you see these first three codes, that is 8421, 2421 and the 5421 BCD code, then they are positive weighted code, because in these codes, all the weights are positive. But if you see this 84-2-1 BCD code, then it is the negative weighted code, because in this code, some of the weights are negative. So this is the example of the negative weighted code. Moreover, this 84-2-1 is also self-complementing code. Now in the previous video, we have seen that the code is a self-complementing code if its 9th complement can be found just by replacing the 1s by 0s and the 0s by 1s. So for example, the 9th complement of the decimal number 1 is equal to 8. And if you see the code for this decimal digit 1, then just by replacing the 1s by 0s and the 0s by 1, we will get the code for the decimal digit 8. Similarly, the 9th complement of the decimal digit 3 is equal to 6. So in the binary code of this digit 3, if we just replace all the 0s by 1s and 1s by 0s, then we will get the equivalent code for the decimal digit 6. So that is why this 84-2-1 is the self-complementing code. Similarly, this 2421 is also self-complementing code. Now if you see these two self-complementing codes, then the summation of all the weights is equal to 9. So in general, for any weighted BCD code, if the summation of all the weights is equal to 9, then that code is a self-complementing code. For example, this 5211 is another BCD code which is self-complementing, because in this code also, if we do the summation of all the weights, then it is equal to 9. Alright, so earlier we have seen that if we have some number in a base B number system, then this is how it can be converted into the equivalent 8421 code. So similarly, it can also be converted into the other BCD codes. So here is the exercise for you. So try to convert this hexadecimal number into the 2421 code. And similarly, convert this binary number into the equivalent BCD code. And also let me know your answer in the comments. Alright, so all the BCD codes that we have discussed so far are the weighted codes. That means all these codes are following the position weighting principle. But this access 3 code is the non-weighted code. That means this code does not obey the position weighting principle. And this is how the decimal digit 0 to 9 are represented in this access 3 code. So as we have seen in the previous video, just by adding the 3 to each BCD code, we will get the equivalent access 3 code. So this access 3 code is also sequential code, meaning that if we see the difference between any two binary code, then it is equal to 1. Or in other words, if we just add 1 to the particular code, then we will get the next code. That means this access 3 is the sequential code. Moreover, it is also self-complementing code. So earlier we have seen that what is self-complementing code. That means for such codes, the 9's complement can be found just by replacing the 1's by 0's and the 0's by 1. So if we take the case of this decimal digit 1, then its 9's complement is equal to 8. Now in the code of this 1, if we just replace 1's by 0's and the 0's by 1, then we will get the equivalent code for the 8. That means this access 3 code is a self-complementing as well as the sequential code. Alright, so now let us see the code conversion. And first of all, let us see how to convert any decimal number into the equivalent access 3 code. So first of all, we will convert the decimal number into the equivalent BCD code. And then we will add 3 to the each BCD code. And that is how we will get the equivalent access 3 code. So earlier we have seen that how to convert the decimal digit 23 into the equivalent BCD code. So in that example, if we just add 3 to the each BCD code, then we will get the equivalent access 3 code. That means this is the equivalent access 3 code for the decimal number 23. Now in general, if we want to convert any number into the equivalent access 3 code, then first of all, we will convert that number into the equivalent decimal number, and then we will find the equivalent BCD code. And after adding 3 to the each BCD code, we will get the equivalent access 3 code. So earlier, we have seen that how to convert the hex number 5C into the equivalent BCD code. So in that example, if we just add 3 to the each BCD code, then we will get the equivalent access 3 code. That means this is the equivalent access 3 code for the hexadecimal number 5C. And similarly, try to find the access 3 code for the given octal number. And also let me know your answer in the comments. So that's it for this video. And I hope in this video, you learn about the different BCD codes. And you also learn some of the important code conversions. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.